As he filed his nomination papers, the opposition's vice presidential candidate, Gopalkrishna Gandhi, justified his efforts to save Yakub Memon, a convict in the Mumbai blast case, from the gallows. He said the practice of capital punishment was medieval and wrong. And in response to criticism from the NDA, particularly the Shiv Sena, Mr. Gandhi said both the Mahatma Gandhi and Babasaheb Ambedkar were his inspiration. They were against death penalty and wanted to abolish it.
Biju Janata Dal with 28 members of parliament decided to back the opposition candidate despite a friendly equation with the NDA government.
The Biju Janata Dal will support Sri Gopal Gandhi as the vice president candidate.
Sabse pehle Naveen Babu ko hamari shukriya hum ada karna chahte.
Sources say that when Venkaiah was told that he was being nominated for the vice president's job, he wept bitterly, saying the party was like his mother and it pained him to leave it. In an electoral college of 787 MPs, Naidu enjoys a comfortable majority. NDA's current strength is 421. NDA with friendly parties is 500 plus. There are some like Mulayam Singh who may go against their party's stated positions. One of the key functions of the next vice president of India will be to manage the Rajya Sabha well, where the opposition is still in majority. That's why Naidu made the right noises.
I have withdrawn myself from the party. I am now above party. I do not belong to BJP now.
After filing his nomination, Gopal Gandhi explained why he had signed the mercy petition for Mumbai blast convict Yakub Memon, an issue raised by Sanjay Raut in the run-up to the vice presidential polls.
I believe that the death penalty and capital punishment belong to the medieval ages. Inspiration from two persons, Mahatma Gandhi, who was against the death sentence, and Babasaheb Ambedkar.
The opposition knows that the numbers are against them, yet it wants to use the vice presidential elections as a rallying point for all opposition parties to come together on a common platform and take on the government. With Srinivasan Jain in New Delhi, Sandeep Phukan, NDTV.
Well, Arvind Sawant joins us from the Shiv Sena tonight, who has taken on Gopal Gandhi for his words on the death penalty. Sushmita Deb continues to be with us. Arvind Sawant, we heard a very detailed clarification there from the opposition's vice presidential candidate. He's saying the death penalty belongs to the medieval age. That's his personal belief. He says he's inspired by his own grandfather, Mahatma Gandhi, and B.R. Ambedkar, who said it was proper to do away with the death penalty. This in no way, his arguing for clemency for Yakub Memon does not make him a backer of Yakub Memon in any sense of the term. Why is the Shiv Sena then taking him on like this?
Fact remains, even after this, that you must understand a gentleman is contesting the election for the vice president. I have highest regard for him. No personal grudges against him, but at the same time, when a candidate is being decided by UPA, one must think very seriously about it. The incident which took place in Mumbai in 2000, that incident where Yakub Memon was the main conspirator of that incident. What is that? It's not an incident. It's a pseudo war. It was proxy war. It was by Pakistan. He has sponsored the boys from India, trained them in Pakistan, brought back to India. All those things have been
proved. Mr. Sawant, the details of the Mumbai blast are known to all, and Mr. Gandhi has made it very clear that he is.
And even after
that, he is against the death penalty.
Mr. Gandhi wrote a letter to the president.
We cannot see Yakub Memon's case in isolation.
The merit of the case.
He has pled against the death penalty for Kulbushan Jadhav in Pakistan. He has pled against the death penalty when he was governor in West Bengal for a convict who was on death row over there. Also, Sushmita Deb, in an editorial today, Aam Aadmi Party's Ashutosh has written that Gopal Gandhi is not the target here. The real target is the legacy that he carries, a legacy of non-violence. Would you agree with that, Sushmita Deb? I'm coming back to you.
When he was a governor, Dhananjay was hanged in West Bengal.
He's going on talking in the middle. I can barely hear you. But I just want to say that every single person on the death row is guilty of a heinous crime. Everybody knows this in this country. But when it comes to opposing capital punishment, it's a separate issue. So whether it is Yakub Menem or whether it is anybody, everybody is a criminal who's been found guilty by a court. But this is a larger issue. Capital punishment by most civilized societies have questioned it. So Gopalkrishna Gandhi ji, as a citizen, questioned the merits of that. You cannot today judge him as a person because he went against a certain policy. Can anybody deny that a court of law, when they declare a death penalty, that that person is guilty of something or the other? Of course they are. But this is a different argument. It's not about Yakub Menon. It could be anybody. Like you yourself mentioned, he's written for Kulbushan Jadhav too. I mean, this is a complete, I think it is a complete twisting the issue and diverting from a separate issue of capital punishment and what his views as a man is about that.
Arvind Sawant, I'm completely out of time, but I will give you a quick rebuttal before we wrap this up.
I strongly condemn this. See, don't defend. Sushmita is defending the case. I feel very poor defense is going on. Fact remains again and again. See, it's not an individual case. A person has killed another person.
Bal Thackeray ji was suspended.
He used to be pardoned. Medieval age.
Bal Thackeray ji was suspended from voting.
He is the man because of whom around 250, 270 people have died in Mumbai. How can you compare it with that? And that is why we have said we do not want to insult his dignity. Let it be very clear from my side. I honor his dignity, but at the same time, we too have
Bal Thackeray ji,
and what we say is that we have reservations about his gentleman.
Because of corruption charges.
Okay.
What are your views on that?
I think Gopal Gandhi ji has stressed his non-political credentials. He is consented to be the vice presidential candidate of a joint opposition, but he's being subjected to this all-out attack by the Sena. We're completely out of time at this point, but we'll continue to get you more on this. For the moment though, let's take a very quick break.